Hi, yeah, morning guys. This is Shao. So right now this is the one of the match that we previously encounter. Currently we have two high priests, Severy and Valentine, and two knight, Shaolin, Spear Knight, and also LK, Crit Knight, and also Yoke, our crowd control mage lah. So this is our gameplay. And this is enemy. Enemy, we have two high priests, one assassin, one mage, and one sniper. So sniper can kill our mage, assassin can kill our priest, and the enemy DPS is wizard. So this wizard can crowd control Shaolin and also Wen because of the freeze, 100% freeze. So with this type of arrangement, when the enemy priest has, let's say, has about 300k HP high priest, 300k plus 300k is equal to about 600k high priest already. So the only solution, if let's say you encounter this kind of tanky priest, the only option is what we can find is we kill the DPS first. So once you kill the DPS, you kill the priest, or you kill the DPS, kill the priest, because they have 3 DPS and their DPS is pain also, and you can say not pain also lah, but we need to kill them and we need to drag the game, because if the game, our party, 3 of us DPS, we only have 3 DPS, man, you see Shaolin, Yoke, and Wen. If 3 of us whack one priest, the 300k HP priest, and controlled by this mage, and will freeze us, so no point. Because 3 of us, if let's say we kill this priest will just click one button, rest, and become 300k HP again. So no point hitting the priest if you encounter 2 priest party. So if let's say both of the priests, their HP is low, you can whack, but not at the current stage. Because the current stage of the game, 300k HP high priest is very high. So the only thing that you can do is to kill their DPS. If they don't have any DPS, they could not kill our priest. Another example, if let's say the party here only have one priest only, so the enemy have 3 DPS, 3 DPS can kill our priest. If our priest die, then the rest of the DPS die. So if your team consists of 4 DPS, alright, 4 DPS, example, this one we're talking about the second scenario. If let's say your team has 4 DPS, you need to kill their DPS. If their DPS down, basically no one can kill our priest. So your job, the 4 DPS need to take down their DPS first. If you take down, their priest just revive, we take down and repeat until the end of the time. Because no point if you 4 DPS only whack one high priest, and this priest will revive the priest again, and you spend about 1 minute 4 DPS person hitting only one priest, then it's pointless because you hit them, whereas these 3 DPS are 1, 2, 3 will hit our priest. If our priest die, then we all die. So remember, if your team only have one high priest, always tell your DPS to kill the enemy, 3 of them, the DPS. If you encounter enemy has a 2 priest scenario, especially these 2 priests is very tanky priest, no point hitting them, okay? No point hitting them, because they just click one button and they will have full HP. So don't ever hit the high priest if let's say they have 2 high priest tanky one. So let's watch the match. Alright, so basically you can see in my point of view, I've been attacking the ranger, alright, and this is the priest down already. Alright, we keep attacking the DPS, and you see the another high priest go and revive the second priest already. So it's a full HP again, very tanky. So take up their DPS first. So what you can see in my gameplay, I keep hitting their DPS, because if their DPS down, they cannot kill our priest. Alright, so we need to take down their DPS first. It's a long fight. If you attack their priest, they just revive only, so no point. They're very tanky. So you take down their most weakest job is like sniper and assassin, because you can see the sniper lifesteal so great, the lifesteal. Okay, the lifesteal is so great. Alright, when hitting this priest, another priest also will hit the priest one. That's why you can see suddenly become full already. So I've been taking the DPS first, kill the DPS first. I cannot aim the wizard because wizard can freeze me. I don't have any freeze resist. You can see the lifesteal. The lifesteal is so imba, you know, pop 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 pop. So we just take down their DPS. And their sniper hitting our mage, you can see our mage HP dropping and up, dropping and up, dropping and up. So basically we need to take down their DPS. So I can see in the gameplay, once we take down the assassin, then we take out all these DPS already, the rest of the priest, the HP will go down. That's why you need to take turn to hit their DPS. Just keep hitting, hit their DPS. Okay, right? You can see. Oh, the sniper is free hitting our mage, the sniper at here, the ghost. Okay, somebody's hitting already, the ghost. Okay. And you can see this sniper is chasing who? He's chasing Valentine right now. He changed target. Alright, so we pull them away and we kill the DPS. Where's the mage? Okay, we kill the assassin, the mage, we rotate. Okay, so Wen is taking down their wizard. Okay, and I'm taking down their assassin. It's a long fight, because the lifesteal meta is very strong right now. Okay, we take down. Because even though if end of the time, it count based on the number of kill. We kill them a lot, we win. Even though just now 0-0, but it will depends on the number of kill and how many people still alive. Okay, so this is how we win for the first round. Let's zoom into the second round. So this is the second run. Same thing also will happen, but we try to aim their DPS, because their DPS 1, 2, 3, the HP add up together also might lower than our 3 DPS, 1, 2, 3 DPS. So we just go in and keep aiming only. Sometimes we also need to press our bot, because you see my HP drop so fast. Oh yo, very pain. So no choice already, we need to just target only. And their mage is regen so fast, the lifesteal. You can see the lifesteal going up, going down, going up, going down. Whereas for the assassin, the ranger changed target already. Hitting me, the ranger hit me, and then I hit back the ranger. Okay, the ranger changed target to who? The ranger hitting. Yeah, hitting our yoke. Yeah, the ranger keep hitting yoke. So I need to kill the DPS first. The DPS also chasing. No? This DPS is chasing yoke. Yeah, the assassin is chasing yoke. That's why I need to target the assassin first. Drag a long game, stun them, pull them. Alright, so we managed to split the two priests around already and try to kill this assassin. Okay, the assassin down. And revive again, full HP. So continue back and remember to attack again. Okay, continue attack. Yeah. Click 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 click. Once their DPS down, we target their priest lor. Okay. I think this one we won. Yes, down already. Okay. Easy lor. So this is what we do usually. We leave the priest last first. I mean we kill the DPS until you switch target left and right, left and right, left and right like that. So this is the score. Oh, let's rewind. So this is the score that we fight for quite number of time. You can see the HP. The healing is so damn long, and they kill us only 2 times. And we kill them a lot, so we won them by the number of kill lah. So hopefully this kind of video can help you to improve your gameplay. And this is only a reference, because we all also still learning. And you can take this video as a reference if you encounter enemy have two priests or two wizards. So thanks for watching. Thank you very much.